Hi everybody, welcome to the cook party. I remember my mom once said, cooking is regarded as science. It is a chemistry between the ingredients and the cook, which brings in life to what we bake. So here we are, all friends of Kitchen Mom's team, ready with the ingredients and ready to bring out the cook in us, with the help of our baking queen, Ms. Shalini Padmanabhan. Hi, Ms. Shalini Padmanabhan, we welcome you. And Ms. Shalini, she is the Woman Entrepreneur Awardee in the baking field. She has worked with Mrs. Rajnikanth for a big project, Iron for India. Her exhaustive celebrity client list includes actors, music composers, and all the leading personalities. Ma'am, it's very, happy to have you once again in our platform. And this time, ma'am insisted that we cook along with her a continental meal for our family this Sunday. So here we are. And I'm going to welcome my other friends of the panel. Hi, Seema. Hi, Neha. Hi, Chandri. Hi, Raujo.
Hi.
Hi, my co-partners, Charu and Shiny. I think we should leave it to the chef to take it over and Shiny to lead us through the program. Have a great fun.
Hi, everybody. Wishing you all a very happy Sunday. I know Sunday cooking is like when, you know, you just want to relax and or do something really special. But this is going to be really fun and something easy. And I'm sure everybody's going to like it at home. So I'm going to teach you all quick methods. And I'm going to tell you all the faults also when you do like sauces and, you know, and easier methods to do. And different variations as and when I'm cooking, I will tell you. It's, you know, for kids, for adults, either way you.
Hey,
shall we start?
Please. So first, what's the new dish?
See, we are going to do a jalapeno cheese fingers, and that's going to be like a starter. And for the main course, we're going to do lasagna, but a healthy version of lasagna. But if you don't want to do the healthy version, you can use your lasagna sheets. And shepherd's pie, another variation, because it's just trying to use with the same ingredients, and the dessert is going to be a bonafé pie.
Perfect. Sounds
so what we'll do is first we'll start with the red sauce, so that as the sauce is cooking, we can get to the starter, let it set in the fridge, and then we can do the, because the dessert, there's not much for it to set. You just need to put the breadcrumbs and set it inside, and by the time you chop the rest of it, it'll set. Okay. So shall we start?
Yeah. Yes, please.
Okay, now we'll start with the red sauce. As you know, the arrabbiata sauce is the Italian sauce, which you can use for pizzas, pastas, anything, even for your sandwiches, for your wraps. You can mix it for any kind of, even when you do stir fry, you can use your, you can use the sauce. So I'm going to now pour some olive oil. If you're allergic to olive oil, you can use any oil you want. But olive oil gives you that nice flavor. And then we have some garlic and onions. So I'm going to first put in the garlic. The garlic is optional. If you want, you can have the garlic, or you don't want, because some of them, you know, Jains don't, you know, they don't have the garlic. So you can omit the garlic if you want. Onions, how much ever you want. If you like lots of onions, you could use lots, but I've just used about, generally for 1 kg tomatoes, you can use like half a handful of onions. I've taken about 2 kilos of tomatoes, because if there's excess sauce, some of them like it really saucy. So you just saute it. Don't let it brown.
Can I ask you a question, ma'am?
Yeah, sure.
So right now we are sautéing the onion in a low flame with garlic.
Yes. Yes. Okay. With olive oil. So just let it saute till it, I won't say turns pink, but don't let it brown too much. I'll show you when I'm adding the, because when you add the tomato sauce and the chili powder and all that, it needs to really cook for at least, say, half an hour.
So how the consistency should be? It should be like thick or it should be fine? Like—
yes, thick. See, actually for every, see, when you want it for pasta, you can have it a little runny. But generally for lasagna and all that, you have it a little thick. So better to make it thick. And if you want, you can keep adding water whenever you feel it. So it stays better when it stays longer. And if you make the sauce, it should stay for a week in the fridge.
Okay.
So now I'll show you the onions. See? They're not brown, but they're kind of cooked.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's like soft. Now the flavor in this is the basil. And it's very difficult getting basil now, but if you don't get basil, you could use dried herbs. You get these dried herbs in this, because that the, you know, you, the minute you chop basil, the whole room smells and it's like, so this is the sauce. This is the tomato that we have pureed, that is boiled, de-skinned, and pureed. So we add this now. So let this cook with some, so you can add salt, pepper, your red chili powder, how much ever you want. That depends on each one's, see, if the kids don't like it spicy, then you don't need to add too much of red chili powder. You can just add pepper. So add some pepper. See, if you want to make the sauce, suddenly you decide and you don't have time to, you know, boil the potatoes and, I mean, tomatoes, you know how long it takes to, you know, cook the tomatoes. It just takes about 15 minutes, but to let it cool and then beat it, it takes almost an hour. So if you suddenly you decide you want to make pasta, you can just take raw tomatoes, chop them, whip them and do the sauce. Nothing happens. It's just that it'll be a little more sour because you've not taken off the skin. So in that time, in that case, you can add a little bit of cream or something to reduce the sourness. Salt.
So is it a right time to add the basil and allow it to boil, or we add the basil?
Let it cook. Let it cook a bit. Let the tomato, you'll see the bubbles.
Okay.
When you see the bubbles, you can add your red chili powder. That you can add how much ever you want, depending on the spice. If you see it bubbling, then you add the basil. Here I have some chopped basil here. I've got the Italian basil.
I've kind of cooked it, and so this is the consistency.
Yeah, you've already cooked it, fine. If it's too thick, you can add this thing. So now mine has started boiling. So I'm just going to add some basil. This gives the flavor for the sauce. And I have some mixed herbs here. So this is oregano. It has chili flakes. It's got rosemary, everything. So I like to add it. If you like more flavor, you can add it.
So like how much it should be there?
It just depends on how much of flavor you like. And you can just add like, say probably about half a teaspoon or something. So if you take this, like just about half spoon of this.
Okay.
And you can also grow your own rosemary at your house.
Wow, please do. I've been trying. It looks very nice. We're not getting parsley and rosemary here. It's such a real...
I have basil here. So this basil is very, the fresh basil is actually really different from the dried one. Really.
Yeah, he's definitely. Right. The minute you chop the basil, the whole house smells, you know.
That's true.
Really nice. It's got a nice smell.
Angrezi tulsi. Hmm. Yeah, basil is a sister of tulsi, right?
Yeah, yeah, it is. It is.
It is. Yeah, I know. Good, great shit.
I have a basil plant in my house, by the way.
Nothing can be better than home grown, fresh.
And see, when you're making a shepherd's pie, yeah, when you're cooking the sauce, you don't have to cook it fully. So when the sauce is like about, say, 10, 15 minutes, you know, done, you, if you're going to use chicken, you add the minced chicken to this and let the chicken cook in the sauce. So it really takes in the flavor. And if you're doing vegetables, you put the vegetables. So any of you doing shepherd's pie can, you know, after probably not take all the sauce, how much ever you want. You take that much, you take the, you know, leave the sauce on another, take it off, take another pan, put your chicken in and keep adding the sauce how much ever you want. Because some of them like it really, see, actually shepherd's pie is, should be really thick. But some of them like it runny, they don't like it, you know, it's too hard. But actually when you put the mashed potato on top, it kind of melts and it's really nice and creamy. So if anybody is doing shepherd's pie, what I would suggest is take your minced chicken, take how much ever minced chicken you're putting in a bowl and add the sauce to it and just cook it along with us.
Shani, my question is, this is the chicken that is not boiled, right?
Yeah, the minced chicken need not be cooked. So what you do is, once it's minced, just saute it for five, just put a little bit of oil, put little onions if you want, just salt and pepper, nothing else.
Okay.
Just saute it for about 2 minutes, 2-3 minutes, and then you put the sauce in. This will cook in like 5 minutes. But what happens is the flavor of the sauce gets into the chicken.
Okay.
So what about the veggies? So we need to mix it before or after?
Like, no, same thing. Just like the, see, because your veggies are not boiled. So when you saute the vegetables, just like instead of the chicken, you saute the vegetables. If you like garlic, you can add garlic to it. But anyway, the sauce has garlic, so it doesn't matter.
Okay.
So you just put in the add.
Are we waiting for this thing to get cooked?
No. Okay. See, now it started boiling, so I'm reducing the flame and I'm going to shift it. So I'll shift it on to the other gas. Now what we'll do is we can do the jalapeno cutlets, the cheese fingers, because when we do that, we need to set it in the fridge for like say 10-15 minutes so that it's chilled and then it's easier to cut and roll.
Okay,
the frying you can do just before you know, everybody sits for lunch. You can do, see, frying is just like any other ordinary cutlet frying. So I'll show you how it's rolled and kept, and then you can fry it just before. Yes, Jen.
Can we use an air fryer to make the cheese fingers?
You can. If you can, what you could do is maybe you can keep take a aluminium foil, just brush it lightly with olive oil or butter or whatever you want and keep it so that it's not too dry. See, because this cheese fingers is kind of moist already, because it's, you'll know when I'm making it, whatever goes into it, you don't even have to fry it. You can actually eat it like that. It's like that.
Okay. Ma'am, but
so I can already get,
we'll make it and show, because we would want to make the fingers, keep it in the fridge. And towards the end, we would want to fry or, you know, do it and see
how. I'll just show you. Yeah, I'll just show you the frying and then you can decide how, whenever you want, you can do it.
Yeah.
Now, I'm sure that you'll be getting the smell of basil. So I'm just going to pop this off onto another pan. I'll leave this aside. Those who like, if you want it even more sour, sometimes, you know, the tomatoes you get are not very sour. So you can add tomato sauce if you want. You can add like a chili tomato and whatever you want.
So I'm going to just let this simmer for a while. I'm going to add some water.
So the three things that you actually need for the lasagna is you need the white sauce, you need the red sauce, and of course cheese for the top and the vegetables. So let this go, and now we will do the cutlet. Let's get to the fingers. Okay, now for the fingers you will need, I will tell you the exact measurements that I have taken so that you'll have an idea. So y'all can keep your butter ready. The first thing that you'll have to pop in for this is the butter and then the milk and then the rava. Let me know when you're ready and then I'll start.
Just one second.
Yeah, sure.
Are we supposed to heat the butter and the milk?
No, I'll show it to you. You don't need to heat. You just lightly melt the butter and then add the milk immediately. Or what I do is, see, it's actually nothing like, it's just making khichdi. Very simple. It's like khichdi. But for khichdi, what you do is you add water and of course vegetables. Here you're using milk and cheese and butter. That's it.
So Shalini.
Yeah.
So we take butter, 50 grams.
Yeah, 50 grams of butter. You don't need to melt it fully. So I'm just going to take it now. See, it's not even, see, if you like it really cheesy, you can add more. So you don't need to melt it really well, like, you know, otherwise it will turn into ghee. So just lightly melt it. Even if it's not melted, it's okay. You can add the milk to it. See, now what I have done is I have used this measuring cup. This is actually 2/3 cup. Even if you take 1/3, any cup you take, the ratio is whichever cup you take, 3 portions of milk, 1 portion of rava, and 1 portion of cheese. If you want to add more cheese, you can add more cheese. So for me, it's here 2/3 cups. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add milk to this. So I'm going to add 3 cups of milk. It doesn't matter if your butter is not melted. And another thing is if your milk is very thick and creamy, you can add 2 cups of milk and 1 cup of water also. So you have that option. You don't have to make it fatty. So we don't let the milk, we just cook it in slow flame. And for this now, you'll have to add salt. And the thing is, you don't have to have the milk. You can even use raw milk. You don't have to boil the milk.
So we add salt to the milk, which is on the gas.
Yeah. And keep it in sim. Don't keep it in a high flame. It's okay if your butter is not melted. You just see mine. My butter is still.
So how much salt we add?
That you can taste and see. Don't add too much because your jalapenos will have salt. So be very watchful of, you can add the salt even in the end. Add just a half a teaspoon now and add the rest later. See, I'm showing you my rava. It's for this 1 cup. The same cup that I took the milk. I took 3 cups of milk, so I'm taking 1 cup of rava.
We add it to the
Add it to the milk. Don't add it when it's very hot because sometimes you'll have these lumps. That's what happens to your khichdi, you know, at times.
Shalini, we've still not added the cheese, right?
Yeah, we've not added the cheese. So let it kind of, you know, thicken. Sure. The rabab will thicken now.
Yeah, I just wanted to be sure.
Yeah, we'll add it in the end because it'll start getting very stringy if you cook it for too long. And then the oil comes out sometimes in the cheese, you know.
And how much butter needs to be put?
See, you can add, if you want it, if you want it with low fat, you can just add 1 teaspoon also. But it's like 50 grams of butter is good enough. You can even add 100 grams. It's like 100 grams butter, 100 grams of rava, 100 grams of cheese, and then your milk is thrice the rava.
It's starting to thicken now.
It's becoming thick.
Yeah.
If it's thickening, then just add your cheese.
Not really.
Yeah. Even mine hasn't.
You know, I always had a fear that when you add salt to the milk is going to go bad.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm surprised that it's like good.
No, nothing will happen. Add your cheese now. If it's kind of, see, mine is getting thicker. I'm actually using this pan, which has got 5 coats of steel, you know.
Mine isn't thicker, so should I wait before I add the cheese?
Can. Should get thick.
When you say thick, is it like the paste?
Kichdi. I'll show you. Mine's getting thick. See? Mm-hmm. It'll become like your khichdi. It'll become like khichdi.
So can we increase the flame to keep it at the high?
Yeah, you can increase it. See, but don't let it, you know, see. It's becoming thick.
So when are we putting aluminum in this?
See. Add the cheese. Mine has become thick. You can increase the flame, but don't let it burn. That's why I said keep it in low flame.
Now, I could see Neha kind of already done.
Okay, I'll show you mine.
Yeah, Neha, I could see that.
You can see it thick. See, mine is thick. So I'm going to add the cheese now.
Mine is far away from me.
Okay, now just see, I'm adding the cheese. And now you can add your jalapenos. Jalapenos, you add how much ever you want. So I'm going to turn off the flame.
So we add the cheese and add the jalapenos and turn it off.
Yes. It? Yeah, because the cheese will start melting and it will become quite difficult to work with. So jalapenos I have used here. I've chopped some and just adding 1 teaspoon. If the kids don't like it spicy, don't add too much.
Oh, my kids love jalapenos. So I'm going to add.
Then you add lots. You can add pepper also if you want for extra spice. Mine is totally done. See? Can you see it being stringy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You see?
Okay.
It's nice and stringy.
Oh, is it? Okay, mine is very thick.
Okay, Shalini, mine is really thick. It's like a dough.
Yeah, that's all. Turn it off. Okay. That's all. It has to be like a dough. It has to set in the fridge.
Okay, Stanley, sorry. One question about the chicken that we are...
Yeah.
I need to put in the sauce in that, right?
Yeah. You need to put your sauce in that.
All of us are making chicken.
Okay, mine is really, really thin. It's like water. What do I do?
Increase the flame. It should cook. Increase the flame and thicken it. Just like... You've put 1:3, no?
Yeah.
It'll cook. See, it's become like, just look at this now. See mine.
Mine has become thick, but it's become a little lumpy.
Yeah, mine is very lumpy. See here, it is like this. Shalini?
Oh no, mine is not that lumpy. I'm better.
You added 3 cups of water? Oh, wait, 3 cups of milk?
Yeah.
Maybe, it's okay. It doesn't matter. It'll set faster.
Okay. So nothing is going to go wrong, I guess.
Nothing will go wrong in this. Everything is cooked. Mine will take longer to set. Yours will set faster. Simple.
Okay.
See.
Okay. Mine is still like water. Like, see. It's still like water. Should I put more suji?
No, is it? How much should you put? 1:3.
I put 1:3, yes.
Yeah, it'll cook. It'll get set. Okay.
Can we see you?
Okay. Now I've got a square pan. Even if you've got a plastic one, it's okay. A square is easier because it's easy to cut. Okay, I'll give you a lot of variations in this. If you don't want jalapenos, you can use olives. You can use, if you don't have time and you know you want, suddenly somebody's coming home and you want to make something and you're making this. You don't have to set it in the fridge also. I will show you one easy. Just take little, roll it. If somebody is like very hungry, just roll it like a cutlet. Put it in your maida batter, roll it in breadcrumbs and just keep it for 5 minutes. By the time your oil is frying, you can try this.
Chandi, just one question. In this rava thing, we only put salt, nothing else.
Yeah, jalapenos, pepper if you want. You can add green chilies also, but since you're using... See, they're all optional. Green chilies, pepper, all depends on how spicy you want it. Okay. I've just put...
Can I put it in this?
Yeah, you can put it in anything. You can put it in round one, preferably a thinner tray. Yeah.
Do we have to grease it before we put?
No. It's already full of butter. No harm. No worries at all. So I'll show you. I'm just dropping it here. Okay, now all of you are doing shepherd's pie or lasagna. If you're doing shepherd's pie, I will show you shepherd's pie itself and show you how to make the lasagna sheet.
Yeah, we all will do shepherd's pie.
Okay.
And that has a combination of veg and non-veg.
Yeah. I'll show you how to do the lasagna sheet and of course the white sauce also.
Shepherd's pie, I'll be doing veg lasagna, not the chicken.
Yeah, so I'll show you what you need to put for the... Okay. Now, this is ready.
We have to flatten it once we put it inside the...
Yeah, preferably. See?
Should we...
Can you see it? Yeah, you can use that. That's fine. Can you see mine? Yeah, that's perfect. This is that. Yeah. So, can you see it now? It won't fall. So, let it cool a bit before you leave it in the fridge because, you know, you can't leave something so hot in the fridge.
It's okay?
Yeah, perfect. You can also do one thing. If you want to level it, keep a bowl of water, put your hands in it and level it because sometimes your spatula doesn't work well. So if you heat a, you know, put a knife in hot water, a blunt butter knife and then level it. So I'm just using this. It's good enough. If you want it really spicy, you can also put some chili flakes. That's another option. And the best accompaniment for this is chili sauce. The reason why is you don't, because it's not very, because it's so cheesy, a mayo dip will not go with this. Or even a mint chutney will go with this. Although it's a conti, it's like yeast meets mist. So that will go. So mine is kind of chilled. So I'm going to leave it in the fridge for a while. Leave it in the fridge. So the reason is because it's so much of cheese, when you leave it in the fridge, it sets and it's easy for you to cut and roll before you fry. So when it's...
How's mine? It's fine?
Yeah, it looks fine.
Show what is done?
Yes, please do. Yeah. Looks fine. You can even leave it in the deep freezer for now because it'll cook faster.
Okay.
Tanpreet, can we have your...
Yeah, looks nice. I can see a lot of jalapenos in it.
I have put corns as well.
Eat this, guys.
Yeah, I think I guess all of us can show it like this.
Yeah. And where are you?
Just flatten it. Yeah, flatten it so it's easier for you to cut in good. And see, when you're frying this, no, we have, I'm just going to show you this because breadcrumbs is something that you get everywhere. Now, these are called panko crumbs. I don't know if you've heard of them. So these are panko crumbs. You can ask for some, it's called panko, P-A-N-K-O, panko crumbs. So this gives you a real crunchy outer. What happens with your bread is, they generally do it with the normal bread. So there is sweet. It's not a salted bread. Even if it's a salted bread, they'll put sugar in it. So whenever you roll any of your cutlets, it gives you that sweet flavor. So this, you can even use it for your chicken, when you're frying your chicken or your vegetable cutlets or your aloo tikki. If you want it really crunchy, you can use this. So this is very, and it's very, it's like, I would say it more like suji actually, but little coarse. And it doesn't, I find that this does not absorb so much of oil like breadcrumbs. I don't know why, but I just found out. I just picked it up recently and I felt it works really well.
Because it has less starch.
The next thing what we'll do is, before we get on to the shepherd's pie or lasagna, do all of you have your the biscuits crumbed?
Yeah.
Now we can set the pie and leave it in the fridge. So then the pie is going to take us only 5 minutes to do. Tell me when you're ready.
Are we supposed to chop the vegetables?
Yeah. If you haven't, you can chop it.
Yeah, so can
chop
you...
it fine. Pardon? You want 5 minutes? You can chop it, no issues. I'll just go and I have to get some. I'm keeping my sauce back here.
Medium size?
Actually, finely chopped will make it better. It's easier to eat.
Guys, you're talking about the veggies?
See, or not
biscuits?
No, the veggies.
So, are we doing
biscuits
the
are made it to a fine powder? So, no, you'll chop the vegetables and keep it. And then we'll do the, or we can do the biscuit base and set it in the fridge.
So the vegetables that we're doing, are we doing it in the sauce?
No, you chop the vegetables. The sauce is anyway half done, right?
Yeah.
Just give me 1 minute. I need to get one more ingredient.
Shalini, my sauce is almost full done. So what do I do?
Turn it off. Turn it off. Keep it. Mine is still a little watery.
So, shall I
saute separately? Yeah, first saute the veggies and then put the sauce on top. So, it depends on how much. Take your pan. So, what you do is, see, for example, see, if you're taking a pan like this, see, for a lasagna, generally a rectangular pan would go well. Anything for things like this, a rectangular pan would go. So if you're taking something like this, say probably about half of this, you will need some vegetables. If you like it really, you know, with good vegetables.
Okay.
So half of this, because you need half vegetables and half sauce, and then it'll, you know, kind of condense and get to a smaller size. Because they'll all cook and really
and the crushed biscuits we need to put in the refrigerator or freezer?
No, no. You've just kept the crushed biscuits, right? I'll show you how to mix it and set it in the pan.
Okay.
Can I show you that first so that can set?
I did it like...
You've already set it? What is that? The crushed biscuits?
Yeah.
Okay, crushed biscuits. No, I thought I'll show it to you. The crushed biscuits are here and the butter is here. I'll melt the butter.
Butter, we do need to put in that?
Yeah, you need to put it. You need to melt the butter. See, if it's 200 grams biscuits, 100 grams, 70 to 75 to 100. See, the butter when you melt, no, you can just keep adding till it kind of firms.
Actually, with the biscuit, we have to keep mixing it.
Yes, I'll show it to you.
Okay.
So it's easy for you to understand. No? I didn't want to do it earlier.
Yeah, in fact, I'm just chopping the vegetables.
Okay, fine. See, when you say pie, everybody feels that a pie should be served in a dish like this.
Yeah.
See, this bonafide pie, another thing is, and when you're doing it for kids, you don't have to do it in the whole, you don't have to use a full pie dish. You can even take individual small disposable cups or something and set each thing separately so you can just serve it to them. If you have small ramekins also, you can put them in those. So it becomes easy to serve. See, what happens is when you, because the condensed milk that we're using is cooked and set in the fridge. So it's caramelized. So it becomes kind of hard to cut also. Okay, so here are my crushed biscuits.
Yeah.
And the butter.
So I'm just going.
I've taken 100 grams for 200 grams of biscuits. If you want more, you can add butter. See, sometimes it may not be perfect, but general is 100 grams, half, 1:2. But this you'll have to use, you'll have to work with your fingers.
Did breadcrumbs have to be refrigerated, or can it be used once it is made, the powder?
No, I didn't refrigerate it. It's just outside, and you see this now, it's crumbly. I'm just going to set it in the pan now.
Mine is little like this.
Yeah, that's okay.
It's kind of halwa.
Yeah. You'll get that nice flavor, you know. You won't even feel like setting it. You'll just feel like eating it.
Just the biscuits and the butter, right?
Yeah.
Has to be breadcrumbs just mixed with the butter, kind of a thing.
Melted,
right?
Butter. Your butter should be melted, otherwise it will just not set.
Yeah, so it's like this, see?
Yeah, that's how it'll be. See, I'm just setting it now. I'm putting it inside. I'm showing you, I'm just trying to bring it to the sides. So that it gives that, so it's like a deep, it's like a well inside.
Shalini, is this okay?
Yeah, that's fine. If you want to bring it to the side, see, generally, if you want to bring the biscuit base, see, my son loves he loves more of the biscuit base than, you know, the stuff inside. So you can have it, you can put the biscuit base even on the side if you want.
Ajay, will you give a break?
Yeah.
Okay, now.
Now, if you have, if any of you are good in, you know, any of you bake cakes and you have whipped topping cream, you can whip the cream and pipe it on top for decoration. See, I'm not showing you that because not everybody would have that and, you know, have a beater and do it. So I'm going to show it to you with Amul cream itself. So Amul cream in the fridge is quite thick. You have to refrigerate this. So this will set, and by the time this sets, we can.
So is this the way I put it in the fridge?
Yeah. Which one? Yeah, you put it on the sides? Yeah, fine.
Mine is like this. It's fine. If you could please see.
Yeah. Fine.
I can put it in the fridge right now. Can we put it in the fridge?
Yes. Let it, because once you put it in the fridge, the butter will harden and your base will become like a crust. You're not using that typical maida base, no? So at least this has got. So I've put mine like this. So this is mine and I'm going to leave it in the fridge. Yeah. You can even leave it in the freezer. Are all your chocolates in the fridge? Are your chocolates in the fridge or outside?
In the fridge.
Okay, keep it out for a while because if it's too hard, you won't be able to grate it. Let it come to room temperature. And use an ordinary grater but the bigger size. Or you can just use a peeler. So that you can peel some chocolate.
I have a Dairy Milk bar. This thing. Can I just use
it? Let it come. Let it not be too hard because you won't be able. It'll start. You'll have small bits. So keep it in room temperature for some time, and then just use your peeler and peel it, and you'll have long strings.
Okay.
Just and keep after you make the thing, then keep it in the fridge.
Okay.
So this is just for the garnish.
There's crumbs by the way.
Biscuit crumbs.
No, yeah. Everybody else has said it.
That's okay. Just give me 1 minute. I need to go bring.
So, what kind of vegetables can go into?
Generally, when it's corn team, you don't use. I don't use beans. I don't use carrots because I have this. You know, beans and carrot are, I won't say Indian vegetables, but not vegetables that you can actually use for a conti dish. So I prefer to use zucchini. You can use baby corn, colored peppers, broccoli. That's what I use. You can also add paneer if you want, if the kids like paneer. You can add kale. You can use kale. You can use baby spinach. You can just chop spinach.
So all of this, we need to saute them first, right?
Yeah, just lightly saute it and I'll show it to you.
Yeah.
I'm just going to do that now. Saute it and then pour the... See, I've made the sauce a little thin because when we are cooking the vegetables along with it, a little bit of the water will evaporate.
So this is for shepherd's pie or lasagna?
For both. For both, you need to cook it, no?
Okay, for both, you need that red sauce.
Yeah, for both, you need the red sauce. The thing is, for shepherd's pie, you need mashed potato. And for this, you need white sauce. That's the only main difference.
So do we need to saute them together or separately?
Saute what?
Veggies.
No, see, now the sauce is there separate. We'll saute the veggies now. Just take some olive oil. So I have some got some colored peppers. Your veggies are chopped for everybody?
Yes, yes, yes.
So I'm adding them. Colored peppers, broccoli, baby corn, and a little bit of zucchini. I'm using the same spatula. We don't have maid, so we are the maid, so use less. Utensil. Or you've got to clean everything. So just, and another thing, I'm sure everybody will know, whenever you're cooking, when you're sauteing vegetables, onion, the first thing you need to add is salt. Because the minute you add salt, it cooks faster and it gets soft very easily. So I've added a bit of salt and I'm sauteing it. I'm adding a little pepper. I'm not adding red chili powder, I'm adding pepper. And I'm adding some herbs so that you can, some flavor gets into the vegetable. If you have basil, you can add basil also. You have rosemary, anything that you like. Celery also works.
You can add basil to it?
You can add, because anyway, if you have, you can add just to get a little bit of flavor inside.
Okay.
You can add some dried, add some dry herbs.
Jayanti?
Yeah.
Can you let me in? I'll come through the phone because my laptop is at battery time.
Yes, I have.
Are you all sorting the vegetables?
Yes.
It's nice and colorful. I'm just covering the lid for about 2 minutes. So it cooks in the steam. See, when you chop the vegetables fine, the kids don't know what veggies are there. And you can make them. And when you add beans and all to this, no, it actually, it doesn't taste, doesn't give you that flavor, and beans, you know, doesn't cook fast.
Basically, we need to add the colorful peppers, baby corn, broccoli,
zucchini.
Zucchini and some.
You have.
But I've added some beans also, as you wrote in the ingredients.
Yeah, yeah, you can add beans. You can. You don't have to. I don't like beans. I'm not very fond of beans, so I don't like to add them. So it's kind of done, actually. It's half, not even half. So now to the vegetables, you can add the sauce. So add sauce and let it cook in the sauce for about 5 minutes. And we'll set that aside and make some white sauce.
Okay, we have got so much of sauce, so we don't need to use the full portion. I think half the
portion. Don't use how much ever you want. Because some of them like it. See, at home, my husband likes, even if you buy him a pizza, he'll pour one half a bottle of sauce on top. It's like totally red. So anything that I make has to have so much of sauce in it. The reason why I said 2 kilos is because you shouldn't fall short. Because suddenly if you have some guests at home and you want it into four portions, you want it six. It'll be useful. You can even use the sauce and make pizzas in the evening or pasta.
Can you see this? Is this okay with respect to the sauce?
Yeah, fine.
By the way,
maybe you can add it.
With so much cooking going on in my kitchen, I'm feeling like some master chef.
Good. Yeah, no, actually, it's nice. See, I'll tell you what. Cooking this Indian food, I mean, is actually a bore. I don't like. Yeah, that's fine. I'm not very fond of, because I feel it takes so long. Yeah. This once you see, you can make the sauce, especially once the school reopens, just make this sauce, make white sauce and leave it in the fridge. It lasts you for a week. Suddenly they ask you for pasta. Just boil some pasta also and keep it. That will stay for 3 days. Boil lasagna sheets and keep it. When you store it in the fridge, if you want to make lasagna sheets ahead, apply a little bit of oil and it will not stick together. Otherwise, they stick. Because I used to run a small cafe and we used to boil these lasagna sheets and have a little bit of oil applied on each sheet and we leave it in the fridge, it'll just stay. Okay, now I'm going to add my sauce. See, I'll show you the color of my sauce. Can you see it?
Yeah.
It's got that real red color.
I want to show off my chicken.
Wow, looks very nice. You've added the sauce?
Yeah.
I think you need a little more sauce.
Okay.
There should be more sauce and less chicken because by the time you cook it, it should be even.
Okay.
See, actually, when you do minced chicken, no, you need lots of sauce. Veggies, you actually don't. So I'm just going to pour sauce into this. Okay, see my sauce with the vegetables. My sauce and veggies. It's not cooked fully, but I'm just needs to be a little thick, okay? See, honestly, to cook a starter, main course, and dessert in 1 hour is a challenge. And I think we're almost doing it. What's the time now? How long have we been cooking? Half an hour, 45 minutes.
45 minutes.
Yeah.
The sauce needs to be slightly thick, right?
Yes.
For shepherd's pie, yes.
Can you just check mine?
Yeah. It's not very thick, no? Is it very thick?
Yeah, kind of.
You're doing shepherd's pie or lasagna?
Shepherd's pie.
Then it's fine. Because a shepherd's pie, it has to be thick. Because when you add your...
I'm doing chicken shepherd's pie and vegetarian lasagna.
Oh, both. Good.
For lasagna, is this okay?
Yeah, that's fine. No, yeah. Little thicker, I think.
Maybe
so that otherwise, your sauce will keep running. No?
Make mine is very thick. Mine is very thick.
It's okay. Because when you add the white sauce, it will start running. That's fine. Okay.
So we need to mix red, white, both the things in the lasagna, right?
Okay. Yeah. So see, generally what you do is you apply the vegetables and then you put white sauce, then you put a layer of
We need to sort separately for both of them.
Two layers of each. For lasagna, you can have two layers or you can just do one. Either way. Generally, you do two so it's easy to cut and, you know, take it out. This is a tall pan for lasagna. So you can have two layers of sheet.
And in the red sauce, then the white sauce as a like...
The veggies, red, white, then you put your sheet, then the veggies again.
Okay.
For the final one, you put the sheet and you put cheese on top.
Okay.
Any sheet is something you are yet to teach us, right? Or did I miss it?
We'll do that. So this is done. Mine is done. I'm going to keep it aside.
Neha's got everything under control. And I'm running from one corner to the other.
Actually, when you mention that, actually, we need to prepare some food. So I prepared my sauce. I crust ready. So that's why I have a few things ready with me. So.
Okay, now we'll get to doing the lasagna sheet. Before we start the sheet, how many of you have already made the dough with maida?
We have not made.
No, whoever is doing lasagna, anybody's made? You've made? Anyway, I'll just show it to you. If you have made dough, take a pan, first pour water, salt and oil and let it boil. So when this is boiling, we can just roll the sheet. It is like 2 minutes when you look at the, when you see. And the another thing is when you buy the lasagna sheet, cooking the sheet takes very long. It takes at least 15 to 20 minutes. But when you do it at home, it just cooks in like 2 minutes.
So it's I have these sheets already.
You already cooked them?
No, I haven't cooked.
Yeah, so you need water. See, it'll be a trial. You cook yours, I will cook mine. We'll see who cooks faster.
Okay, so what am I supposed to do? These are like the raw ones. So what am I supposed to do?
Just take a pan of water.
Okay.
And let it really boil. Add salt and ordinary oil to it. Okay. Add salt to it.
And Shalini, how are we supposed to make the lasagna sheets with the zucchini?
That I will show you. I'll show you both. I have the zucchini here. Need to peel it straight. And see, zucchini has water. So if you're just going to put it like that inside, when you cook it again, you'll have some water coming in. So what I do is peel it, just put it, brush the pan with oil and just put it on the pan for 2 minutes and take it out. Just like a sheet. That's it. So this is actually a low carb. So the entire lasagna will be low carb. You don't have any carbs in it.
Oh, that's awesome. And what about the like white sauce?
See, for the white sauce, what you can do is you can just take, maida has carbs. So you can just take cream and cheese and mix it and put it on top. Or you can do a cauliflower mash instead of this. Instead of potatoes, just like how you boil potatoes and add milk and salt to the mashed potato. For shepherd's pie, you can do a cauliflower mash. Cauliflower mash is nothing but grating the cauliflower. You don't need to boil it. Just grate the cauliflower, add cream and little bit of cheese and just sprinkle it on top. So that sets, that cooks as you're
top layer.
So this is my dough, Shalini.
That's your dough? Okay. I've also made some dough.
And I'm also good.
So here's my dough.
Basically,
how many sheets we will
need of water and remaining
will be needing?
Need about four sheets. Depends on four sheets for if it's for four people. Actually, depends on
how many of these.
Just cook four. I'll tell you why. Because sometimes it sticks, and you know, better to put two at a time.
Yeah.
It's basically 1 cup of maida and a little bit of water and oil, and then we make this dough.
Exactly. Just like your roti. My table is clean.
I haven't made that dough. Neither I have to eat. So I'll be doing only with these.
Okay. I'll show you this. I've not rolled it like a roti. I've rolled it long. See my sheet? Here, look at my sheet.
Okay.
As thin as you can. Jayanti, this is my sheet. I've not made it round. I've made it long.
Okay. So basically, we take a balin, we bale it, and then we cut it straight.
Once you know the cost of this, you won't go anywhere near buying it. Buying and storing makes a lot of sense. But in the lockdown period, sometimes you don't get the sheets.
So I've made it with the entire dough, right?
No, I've just taken I've taken only one ball.
Okay.
For this, I'm doing one at a time because it will start, it's not boiled as yet. I'm waiting for the water to boil.
If you could please see my vegetables, are they looking fine?
They're fine.
They're fine?
If you want more sauce, you add sauce. See, the sauce depends on each one's taste.
Okay. Yeah. But in lasagna, we'll be putting sauce at the bottom as well, no?
Yeah. The sauce with the veggies. What I'm doing is, that's why I'm cooking the veggies with the sauce. If your veggies has very little sauce, you can put a little bit of plain sauce and then put the veggies on.
Okay.
But when you cook it, the flavor comes, no? It tastes better.
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
I'm going to add some oil to this.
Oil to what?
To the water that's cooking. I'm just adding one. The reason why you add oil is so that it doesn't stick.
How much?
Just add two spoons. Two spoons of oil. Pardon?
How much oil?
2 spoons. Try to roll it as thin as you can. See, if you want atta, you can also do it with atta. You can do 50-50.
So I can add paneer in shepherd's pie or in lasagna?
See, if you don't want to use cheese, you can actually mix paneer instead of cheese for the topping.
See, adding paneer, it's, see, when you look at shepherd's pie, you're not supposed to add because it's a country dish. But you can add, see, everything is made like, even our Chinese is not like the perfect Chinese, it's all to our Indian taste. So the kids like paneer, just add them.
Do we have to half cook it or like properly cook it, like the boil these sheets?
No, the sheets will be fully cooked. Because the minute you put it, see, you see this raw color now, the minute you put it inside, it'll just cook in 1 minute.
I'm not getting the sheet. What went wrong? This is the
sheet. Just like a chapati maav, roll it, that's all. Add some maida and just roll it. You put little bit of oil in the dough. Make it pliable to your atta dough, just like how you make your rotis. Okay, my water is boiling.
Shalini, this is okay? Is this fine?
Yeah, you can, any size, ma. Any size. If you have a round pan, you can make it round.
Ma'am, you are showing off.
Exactly.
Yeah, because first
time you become a top chef.
Yeah, I can see how you're doing it like a pro, like this and this, and I'm.
I know.
Yeah. Okay. First time in getting it right. That's why
you need a spoon like this with holes to take it out so that you drain off the water. So my water is boiling. I'm going to insert it inside.
So this is the sheet, and you put it inside the water.
Yeah, one at a time.
But the water should be boiling. Yeah, better to do one at a time. Otherwise, it's a pain. Okay. It doesn't take long at all. You just see, I put it inside. It just float. If your water is boiling, the sheet will float. Otherwise, it will just go. It will stick to your pan.
This is the way I need to wear it with.
Yeah, you can make it thicker if you want. Mine is already boiled and cooked. That's all. That's it.
So do I need to boil them or do I need to sort them little?
No. Which one? Your zucchini or that's your...
Zucchini.
Zucchini, just keep it like that. I'll show you. I'll sort it now. Now see, it's done. I've cooked it. I'll take a plate now. Wait. See the sheet? It's cooked already. Jayanti, I'm going to take a look. The sheet is cooked. That's all.
Okay, Shalini, you can see mine also.
Yeah, it's cooked.
Looks like.
Seema ma'am, you are wrong.
Oh, like what expert you're feeling here?
Next year, the professional and the novice cooks are going to be in separate batches.
Neha, are you good?
She's become one master chef.
I'm trying both ways.
Tanpreet, are you enjoying?
Yeah, is this fine? Is this fine?
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah. Your peel is really good here. Sometimes it just doesn't peel, you know.
So basically, when the water is boiling, we just put that and just chop it. And then
that's all. It just cooks. It cooks in no time. This cooks faster than your hardened lasagna sheets.
Okay, let's see what happens to mine. Come on, girls, pray for mine. Mine is half floating, half is sunk.
That's okay. You just cook, ma. I'm putting my next one inside.
It's like a poor version of puri.
Yeah, it's like a puri, but the water, this is water and mohit.
Yeah, oil free. You can even do it with,
What am I supposed to do with them now?
Yeah, I'll show you now. I'll remove this now. These sheets are over.
Can I do half maida and half zucchini sheet?
Yeah, half zucchini.
do. It's okay.
It's not like zucchini will burn out or something?
No, it won't. It won't.
Why should it burn out?
You know what? It's so much fun that Shalini is from Chennai. Neha is from Gurgaon. Ravjot is from Gurgaon. And Chanpreet is from Gurgaon.
I'm from Delhi, Delhi, Delhi.
From Dwarka. Chanpreet is from Delhi. Tiny from Gurgaon. Maru from Chandigarh. I mean, we are cooking together.
National integration.
Okay, I have a question, guys. Mine is looking like a very slimy little thing. Is that how it's supposed
to be? That's how it will be. Very, very slimy. That's how it will be. Right? Just separate them.
We need to make a white sauce as well, right? For the lasagna.
Yeah.
On Mona, it has to be Neha or it has to be Seema Ma'am. Showing off. Bye. People have to be banned for the next one.
Yeah, I don't know where am I right now. I'm so messed up. I don't know what am I doing.
See, it's your mistake. I thought we need to prepare all those things. So I did it already. The class started.
I haven't made white sauce. You all have made white sauce. No, no,
but
me.
No, please tell me how do we have to make it?
I know exactly. Tiny, you know that there's no order in right now. Your family is going to really.
But I have no clue where am I right now. I'm so messed up.
Okay. Now the zucchinis are peeled.
Yeah. How do we set in the oven and the plates? Oven plates.
No, no. Yeah. No. What we'll do is we'll keep. See, we peel the zucchini. Now what we do is take a pan, apply a little bit of oil. Just put it for 2 minutes and take it off. Just so that it dries.
So, I think I have 10 pieces. All of them?
Pardon?
I have 10 pieces. 10 of these strips.
Yeah, you see, zucchini sheets, you can put how many ever you want. The lasagna sheets, you can't put too much because it will get too slimy, no? It will be an overdose of maida. So let this just go. Let the pan get hot. And then we'll do the white sauce. And we will set the lasagna in and then get to the cutlet, get to the rava cheese fingers and the dessert.
Yeah, we might have to
speed up. Yeah,
do we need to preheat the microwave?
Are you going to use a microwave or the convection oven? Whatever you're using,
convection. Yeah,
preheat it so it saves us some time.
Okay,
okay. Now, here are the sheets, the zucchini sheets. I'm heating my tawa. My sheet is longer than the tawa. Just cook how many ever you want. I'm just putting it on the tawa. See, the reason why you put it on the tawa is to just take off that moisture.
Yeah.
In case you don't have time for that, you can use a tissue and just take off the, drain out the water. That's it. And so that you don't have a raw taste also. That's it. I'm done with mine.
So do we need to cook both the sides?
Yeah, better. Just 2 minutes only. So I'm going to keep all this on a plate and use it when we're. Please post your reviews from the family after you've had your lunch. I definitely would like to listen to it, you know, whether it's good or bad or whatever it is.
My family is brutally honest.
Mine too. Okay, now for the white sauce. Shall we do the white sauce? Everybody is ready?
Yeah.
So we need to preheat the microwave. And for how many minutes?
10 minutes. 180 degrees, 10 minutes.
Are you using the microwave?
Pardon? So you need the electric oven. No, if you want it brown, you can use a microwave also. But if you want it really brown, then you use use the electric oven. Okay, so now for the white sauce, see, I'm going to teach you a very, very simple method of white sauce. See, generally, when you do white sauce, the recipe goes, melt butter, add maida or corn flour, saute it for a while, and then add the milk. That is the normal recipe. What happens is when you saute the maida, after you add the butter, sometimes you find lumps. And it becomes very difficult for you to make the white sauce. So the easiest way, melt the butter, take a bowl, put your maida or corn flour, add the milk, whisk it. Mix the maida, and easier way is put everything in the mixie and one churn.
What is the outcome again?
For the white sauce, you need butter, milk, corn flour or maida for thickening. Mm-hmm. If you're gluten intolerant, you need not use either of the two. You can use arrowroot flour also or tapioca starch, whatever you want. Mm-hmm. Generally, you melt the butter, then put the flour, roast it for a while and then add the milk. Sometimes what happens when you do this and you add the milk, it starts becoming fine lumps.
Yeah.
So the easiest method I do is heat the pan, put the butter, mix the maida with the milk in a bowl.
How many spoons of maida do I put?
See, generally for one packet, I make excess and keep. So I take one packet of milk, that is half a liter of milk, I use 3 tablespoons of maida.
I'm using corn flour then?
Yeah, three, same thing. See, you use lesser, if you want, you can add more. Because once it gets too thick, then you have to keep on adding milk. It's easier to add the corn flour later than add anything else. So I'm just going to take butter. You need about 2 tablespoons butter. Shall I start the white sauce?
Yeah.
So here's the butter. I have 500 ml of milk. I have a whisk here and I have a bowl. But all of you have your mixie, you have your mixers next to you, no?
Yes.
Yeah.
Don't put all the milk in the mixie because it will just splurt out. So what you do is take your 3 tablespoons of maida first. So it's 1, 2, and 3. So this is 500 ml milk. So I'm just adding half of it. See what I've done. I've taken half the milk and mixed it with the maida. So you don't have any lumps in this. Or use a hand blender. You can use a hand blender also, or use a mixie, either one. So you have a hand blender, you can use a hand blender also. The hand blender comes in very, very handy when your white sauce gets lumpy. Your white sauce gets lumpy, or when you're making custard at home and suddenly it becomes, you find lumps in the custard and you don't know what to do. Don't panic, let it cool. Use a hand blender, put it inside your custard, just churn it. You won't have any lumps. This is the easiest trick. Keep some extra milk with you in case it gets too thick. So I'm just melting the butter. If you like garlic, you can add garlic to the white sauce if you want. When you're making an au gratin, you can add garlic and onions, you saute it in butter, it gives you a lovely flavor.
How much butter?
I've taken about 1 tablespoon. You can take 2 also if you want, if you want it really creamy and cheesy. So now I'm not going to add the milk with the maida first. I'm adding the leftover milk, the plain milk to the butter.
I've actually made the sauce.
You've made the sauce? Good. Okay, so I'm adding the leftover milk to the butter. Add the milk to the butter. Plain milk, not the one with the maida. And then add this. Please add salt, pepper, add salt for your white sauce. A little bit of pepper. You can add nutmeg also if you want, but I don't. If you want your white sauce really cheesy, you can add some cheese also, but add it in the end. White sauce ready?
Sauce ready?
Yeah, okay, that's fine. Maybe you can thicken it. Yeah, once it cools down, it'll thicken, it'll harden. We'll put the lasagna in the oven and get to the desert. And start frying the cutlets. Anybody's white sauce becoming lumpy?
Mine is done.
Okay, done means good. Mine's also done. You can also add herbs to the white sauce if you want. Or just sprinkle it on top finally when you...
Shalini, you think this is good enough?
Yeah, fine.
Or white sauce?
No, it's okay. If you want, you add milk. Not necessary. Mine's also done. Yeah, that's fine. It'll get thick after some time.
Yeah, mine is also done.
Okay, let's...
Okay, now next.
Now let's line the lasagna and get it into the oven. So by the time we do that, we'll finish the dessert and start frying the fingers.
And what about the shepherd's pie? We are still in the middle.
Shepherd's pie, there's nothing. You finish that mix, no? Next, the mashed potato.
Mix it. We don't have to set it in the oven or something.
Yeah, when we're doing the lasagna, shepherd's pie, everything, whoever was doing shepherd's pie, it'll go into the oven. Now, whoever's doing shepherd's pie, take your mashed potato.
No, right now, what are we doing? Lasagna or shepherd's pie?
You're doing both? Are you doing both?
Yeah.
All of us are doing both, so you can just tell us. So we
okay,
can...
now, so now to do the shepherd's pie, we need to make the potato mash. So mash your potatoes. The trick in mashed potatoes is when the potato is hot, add hot milk, add some butter, add some cream. I add cream, I add butter, I add a little bit of cheese.
Our mashed potatoes are not hot right now.
That's okay. Add hot milk to it and mash it.
Okay. We have just peeled them and mashed it already. So
I'll show you.
So can we do one by one? Can we do the lasagna first and then get to shepherd's pie?
Yeah.
So. Fine. Okay. We'll do the lasagna.
Yeah.
We'll do the lasagna.
Yeah.
So what I'll do is I'll do it on a small pan. So if I can do the shepherd's pie also for you. So I'll do two small portions so I can show you both. If it makes sense.
Can I use things for lasagna?
Pardon?
Can I use this for lasagna?
Yes, you can use that.
I have to grease it now?
No need. Oh, that's a good idea. I can use my bread loaf tin. Didn't think about that.
Neha and Seema ma'am, front benches. Kahan pe rahe abhi?
Done with all.
I think I just have to set it.
I have even cleaned
for, Shalini to tell us how to do the layering.
Okay. Now your pan is ready. So you're going to do two layers.
Yeah.
So first you put the sauce with the veggies. Okay. So sauce with the veggies first. Then put white sauce. And then put your sheet.
Okay.
So lasagna, guys.
Hello? Yeah.
One pressure, please, if
repeat.
And then your white sauce.
One second. Shanli, please repeat once again.
First your thing. Layer of vegetables with the red tomato sauce. Sauce. Mm. And then you put your white sauce. Then you put your lasagna sheet. I'll show you. Kids like a lot of white sauce in it. See? One layer of... And then the layer of... And then the lasagna sheet, which we made, goes perfectly as one sheet. See? I'm putting the sheet on top.
But then we can cut it if we have not got the sheet.
Yeah, you can cut it. So my one layer is done. See.
So we have only
how many layers do we do?
You have to put one more layer. You have to use one more layer. Two layers.
Oh, is it?
So my layer is also done.
Two layers.
I put only one layer. Is that okay?
That's okay.
Yeah, because I dumped all my veggies at the bottom.
Yeah. That's okay. It's okay.
Okay. Is it like this? I've done it.
Yeah. It has filled it in the top. Then put white sauce on top. Little bit of, or just grated cheese on top. Just put grated cheese on top.
Okay.
One layer of this is done now. One layer of this, okay, two layers.
Yeah, two layers. Then one more layer of veggies. One more layer of veggies, one more layer of sauce, and then finished. And on top, be generous with your cheese.
I guess we can use cheese slice, right?
Yeah.
The slice can be used.
Yeah, you can use slice. Wait, after you put some cheese, please grate some oregano on top. So here's my cheese. Now for this, you got to keep it at a real high temperature because there's practically nothing to cook. You just want the cheese to melt and brown a bit.
So what is the temperature in the oven and what time, how much time?
200 degrees, that's 400 degrees Fahrenheit. And I'm sprinkling some herbs on top.
200 degrees Celsius.
Okay. So my lasagna is done. With some herbs. I'm putting it into the oven.
Be the,
what, 10 minutes should be done.
Yeah, and it goes top and bottom or only top or?
Top and bottom.
Minutes?
10 minutes. Just check till your cheese melts and becomes, because it shouldn't burn. Each oven varies in temperature. So 10 minutes should do. Just open it and check after 10 minutes. If your cheese is brown, it's done.
Okay.
I'm just going to show you the mashed potato.
Yes.
the baking, right?
Yeah, so I have the potatoes here. You're doing shepherd's pie, right?
Yeah.
The potatoes, mash it.
Lasagna, Shalini.
Lasagna, 10 minutes.
The oven, the heat from down below, right?
Yeah, both.
Both?
Up and down.
Up and down. So, mashed potatoes, what do we
do? Your potatoes are mashed? Yeah. See, mashed? Okay, now I'm going to add some butter, salt.
Are we supposed to keep this in the gas oven?
Which one?
The potato mash?
No. I'm just, because it's going to bake.
I have put my this thing in the oven. Now we are doing the mashed potatoes, right?
Yeah, now mashed potatoes.
Yeah.
Just add a 1 spoon of butter. Add a little bit of butter. Now just take some milk and heat it.
Any salt, anything else?
Salt, pepper if you want.
So we have to heat the butter and add the milk in the pan.
No. See, you don't need to do it in the pan at all. You just take a bowl. I'm just using an ordinary glass bowl. Just take the mashed potato, add butter, add hot milk. Let your milk be hot. I like my mashed potato really creamy and cheesy. So what I do is I add a little bit of cream also. I have kept some cream outside, so I'm adding a little bit of cream. Because when it bakes for shepherd's pie, it tastes really nice. See, when you add hot milk, the butter melts. That's why. Otherwise, you do it when your potatoes are hot. Pardon? Milk. Heat the milk so your butter will melt. Salt, pepper, that's all. If you like garlic, you can add garlic, but I'm not adding.
Instead of
what should be the consistency, it should be like very runny. Thick.
No, not runny.
Mine is a bit slimy. Can I use coconut milk for this?
You can use. If you have to make it vegan, you can. You can use it.
Okay.
I can use coconut milk if it is vegan.
Yeah, you can use. Then you can skip the butter also. You don't need the butter. Here. Can you see the consistency of the mashed potato?
Yeah, mine is
a
little like that.
If you want it nice and smooth, you can use your hand blender and mix it.
Okay. Make it with the coconut milk and no butter.
Yeah.
If you want to make it,
okay, so I'm taking the bowl now. Now, those who are using chicken, see, generally the ratio, you can also add peas if you want. Actually, the original recipe has peas.
but I don't use peas because most of them don't like peas. Okay, so tell me when you're done with the mashed potato, so I'll just show you the topping. Because I'm going to layer it. Pardon? If you have bread at home, you can toast bread or garlic bread. It goes well with garlic bread. Pardon? So I'm done with this. I'm going to put the layer the shepherd's pie.
Yeah. Okay.
So we're just putting it in a bowl?
Yeah, any bowl you want. I've taken a glass one so you can see how it looks like. See? And then you top it with mashed potatoes. See, if you don't want potatoes, you can use, like I said, mashed cauliflower. This, for shepherd's pie, you don't have two layers, you just have one layer. So all the chicken or veggies that you've done, put it on the base and add the potatoes on top. It's actually a full meal because you have your carbs. My lasagna is done. You put cheese on top and that's it.
Shalini, it's chicken at the bottom and then the
mashed potato on top. What you can do is you can add cheese to the mashed potato and mix it and put it on top if you want to avoid the cheese on top. So it's done. This goes inside.
For how long?
Same 10 minutes. Because everything is cooked. So you just want it to, you know, kind of all the sauces to mix in. So the potato, the milk, the butter, everything melts and gets into the sauce on below. So here's mine. So you can see the two layers. See, you see the two layers. Yeah, perfect. Put into the oven. Now for those who are doing lasagna, you'd put the lasagna, instead of the lasagna sheet, you all have put the zucchini sheet inside.
Yeah,
That's the only variation. If you don't get zucchini, you can also use aubergine. Okay, my lasagna is done. Okay. It's too hot.
Anybody's lasagna done?
Yeah, mine just needs to get brown on the top.
Mine is done.
Mine is done.
Okay, I'm showing you my lasagna. Can you see it?
Yeah, nice.
Yeah, very nice.
Mine has not come to that level. Do I keep
it
a little more?
Yeah, it should lightly brown.
Mine is made as well. I made mine.
Mom, we can't see
you. Shall we do the pie?
Yes.
So now we move on to our dessert.
Yeah. We need to take out that. Take out your condensed milk. Just clearing up the place so we get more space.
Bananas.
Okay, now what the layers for this is, first the biscuit base. Okay. And then I want all of you to take out your condensed milk which is in the fridge.
Okay.
Open it and see how it looks like. This is the color you should get. It's not watery. It's kind of hard.
No. We have cooked it for so long.
You cooked it for?
1.5 hours.
Yeah. What is the color?
It's still the same. I didn't find any difference.
See, mine, I'm turning it upside down. It doesn't drop.
No, it will drop. So I guess then I'll just notice.
It's okay. No, it doesn't matter. You can use that. No worries at all. Just take a spoon.
Mine is also the same. No, it's liquidy.
See mine.
It's liquidy again.
Yeah.
Mine is also the same.
What have you used? Amul?
Yes,
how many Nestle. Of you have used Milkmaid?
Myself. Nestle. Milkmaid.
Nestle?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Let's see. Then maybe there's a... Okay, open yours. How was yours? I don't think anything will go inside the pie. Everything will go inside my mouth.
Yeah.
I just love licking this, you know. It's like.
Take that out. This thing, lasagna.
If it's done, take it out. See my.
I'll just show you.
Condensed milk.
Mine is liquidy, but we can just throw it down and maybe put it later.
Mine is like this. See.
Is it done or shall I do it some more?
Brown, dark brown. How is yours?
Yeah, mine is also
watery.
No, not watery. Not watery.
Thick, no?
Yeah.
See, mine is like.
Mine is the same.
Just look at mine. It doesn't fall. Put it on the entire base. Apply it on the entire base. It's okay if it's runny. No worries. The minute you set it in the fridge, it'll stay cold. So it doesn't matter. Actually, it's easier to eat when it's runny because you can cut it well.
Okay, my lasagna is done.
So how many layers of this are we doing?
This is only one layer.
Of this one. So I apply all of it? Should I just put all of it?
No. Don't put all. It'll be too sweet. Just one layer on the base. Because there's no sugar in anything else.
Honey, can you please repeat?
I'll just show it to you.
Yeah, basically the pull that the breadcrumbs thing, you set it in the fridge.
Yeah. And then now you're going to line the caramel.
So we just pour the Milkmaid caramel on top.
On the base.
We don't add bananas right now.
No, after this is the bananas, then the cream, then the chocolate. It's got five layers totally.
Okay, so
now what do we have to do with the bananas?
No, first apply the condensed milk all over.
I've done that.
Done.
Yeah, done. Now?
Right. Slice your bananas thin. Slice your bananas nice and thin.
Guys, sorry, can somebody help me? On top of the biscuit, we need to put the
caramel.
Hello?
Caramelized condensed milk, see. Okay? Can you see it?
Yes, you can.
Done.
That, it was so thick beneath. It was just watery in the top.
Yeah, right.
That's why you got to mix it. Okay, now take your bananas and slice them.
Slice it what?
Thin.
So,
I'll show you how to layer it.
All right, gently at the bottom, it's nice and thin.
Yeah.
You can slice it diagonally. Instead of rounds, just for a, see like this, I've made it oval, like you slice your bruschetta, no? Slice about, if it's small bananas, I think you need about two or three.
And we just layer it on top?
Yeah. One whole layer, that's it. Bananas should be nicely, should be thin, no?
Yeah, Seema ma'am, Neha, how are you guys?
All good. Feeling hungry. Feeling hungry.
About me and Tiny.
Feeling very hungry.
That's the front bench.
We need to put the bananas all over?
Yeah, all over the base.
Okay.
You need about.
Be quiet as Champreet. I guess she's going to do a marvelous job.
I don't know. It's just going on. I don't know.
See, whether it looks nice, people in the house should say it tastes nice.
Yeah,
I'm more worried about that.
And you also will looking nice.
Okay, I'm done. I'm going to show you before I put the next layer.
I'm done.
See, if you all have whipping cream, you can pipe it. Okay, so the bananas are sliced. So this is the third layer.
Yeah, so it's like this.
Yes. Now what we need to do is apply the cream. See, I've kept my Amul cream in the fridge, so it's thick.
Okay, we'll also put
So what I'm going to do is, see, I have to do a little bit chef way, no? See, I have a piping bag, so I'm going to show it to you.
But if you don't,
it's professional, let it look. So I'm just, if you have, just apply the cream all over. Just put spoonfuls of it on top.
So without putting any sugar or something on it?
You don't need, there's so much of caramel down, no? And there's going to be chocolate on top.
Okay.
So this is just plain Amul cream.
But my cream is not that thick, if you could please check.
It's okay. It's okay if it's not thick. You can just pour it on top. It's going to set in the fridge.
Okay.
Mine has been in the fridge. Generally, when I buy the cream, I always leave it in the fridge. So it stays. I never leave it out because of the heat, no?
Yeah.
You can just take an ordinary Ziploc bag also, put it inside, and cut the end.
Okay. Yeah, that's also a nice idea.
No, you don't need a piping bag.
No, you can do like this. This is your cream. Chop it off on the edge and then start squeezing it off.
Yeah. Just see this? Can you see it? It's got these small rosettes.
Yeah.
And that's it. Your dessert is done.
Yeah.
The fifth layer. The chocolates.
We have to put much cake after the chocolate is done.
That's it. Ready to eat.
Okay.
Check if your shepherd's pie is done. And it's getting done. So my pie is ready.
Put this in the fridge.
Yeah, leave it in the fridge. By the time we finish our cutlets, we can probably, you all can lay your table and take a picture. So I'm leaving mine in the fridge. That's it. Now let's get to the starter. Now everything is ready. The starter will be done like in 5 minutes.
Just 1 minute. We are just putting the chocolate.
Yeah. Sure. I'll get the other stuff ready then, by then.
Annie,
doesn't matter if the cream is runny, because anyway, when you take it, it's going to melt.
You need to put it in the fridge, right? Not the freezer.
No, no, leave it in the fridge. Because if it gets to the freezer, the condensed milk will really harden and you will find it very difficult slicing it.
Okay.
Fridge is a better option. And this is one dessert you can actually make it. You can make the base and keep well in advance.
You can use some Hershey syrup as well on the top.
Yeah, you can do that. Just for the garnish, no? See, the top garnish is all left to your imagination.
I love kids' greed.
Now we are getting to the next one.
We have to heat the oil.
Yeah, you all ready? Because I thought by the time we heat the oil, you can take the, God, I put mine in the freezer and forgot. I left mine in the freezer and forgot. Wanted it to sit.
Mine looks something like this. It's fine.
Yeah. Okay, now. Yeah, fine. My cheese fingers are ready to slice. So before we slice it, let's heat the oil so it'll be done.
My lasagna looks like this. It's fine.
Why do you have to take this out from this mold?
It's fine.
It's fine.
Take it out of the mold because it'll be easier for you to cut. Just use a knife on all four sides and overturn it. It'll
okay,
come.
Okay. Just see. It's ready.
Yeah. You can slice it now.
How thin are the slices? Like fingers?
Yeah, fingers. You can do it anyway. You can make them as squares or small cubes, and you can even put one toothpick on top and give it like a mini starter, no? So. Okay, before we slice it, let's heat the oil so that we save time.
So I did not keep this in the freezer.
You didn't keep it in the fridge. It's okay. Doesn't matter.
No, I did not keep it in the freezer. I kept it in the refrigerator.
Yeah, you should keep it in the refrigerator. I left it in the freezer and forgot to take it out.
So now we pull it out and slice it.
Yes, slice it. Meanwhile, before you slice it, just turn on the gas and put your oil to heat.
So I have to basically put it in the air fryer.
Yeah, put it in the air fryer, correct.
We can do small balls of it as well, no?
Yeah, you can do small balls, anything, ma'am. Pardon?
After slicing,
now after slicing, what we do is now the usual way you make your cutlets, no? Mix water and maida. Take it a little. I'll show you. With thick paste.
And some salt and something else.
Something else. Just maida. Just take maida and take some water. Don't make it very runny. Let it be a little thick.
We are going to shallow fry it or deep fry it?
Deep fry. You can shallow fry also. But shallow fry, what will happen? It will start sticking because it's got a lot of cheese, no? So cook it on a high flame. See, I've made my batter like this, the maida and.
So so we have to dip it in this maida thing and put it in the air fryer.
Maida and roll it in breadcrumbs and fry it. So what you do is take these breadcrumbs onto a plate. And another trick, I won't say a trick, an easy method is always keep a bowl of water, especially when you're making cutlets. Keep a bowl of water so that every time you dip your hand, you put your finger in this so that it doesn't stick. So I'm taking this first one. Can you all see or should I wait? You want me to wait?
Just 30 seconds.
Yeah, sure. Level time I look for my problem. Forgot about the ship. That's fine. I want to take out. Busy doing this, I forgot about my ship. Yeah, my shepherd's pie is done. Here's a shepherd's pie done. Everybody, shepherd's pie is done?
Yes.
It isn't brown.
It isn't brown, huh? Then you need to cook it a little more. That's why when you do it at 200 degrees, it, for me, in 10 minutes, it browns. When you're ready, I'll show you the.
Yeah, I'm ready to go. Guys, what about you?
So you need three things: a bowl of water, just ordinary tap water, maida mixed with water, and your breadcrumbs. Okay, and a cloth if you want. So first, you take your cheese finger, dip it in the maida and place it on this. Don't roll it with this maida hand because all the breadcrumbs will stick to your fingers. So immediately put your hand in plain water and then roll it. You do one without washing your hands, you do one washing your hands, you'll see the difference. And then you know why I'm asking you to keep a bowl of water. Any cutlet you do, always keep a bowl of water. You don't waste the breadcrumbs also. Because what happens, the more and more maida keeps sticking to it, half the breadcrumbs you actually dump. So I'm dipping my hand in water into the maida. My oil is already hot. See, when you tell kids it's rava, cheese fingers, they think, oh, rava, you know, it kind of actually puts you off. But when you, you know, have a nice fancy name to it, and I'm quite sure nobody would have tried this out. In fact, this is a every year birthday snack at my friend's place. I've been having this from, I think, like the fifth standard. And this is some, this was one dish that I always wanted to learn. And it's become a standard menu at all the parties at home for vegetarians. Any of you started frying?
Yeah.
Jayanti, have you put yours in the air fryer? See, this is one starter you can make a day ahead, because as the cheese, you know, really becomes chill and hard, when you fry it, it really starts, you feel that cheesy taste inside. You can add more cheese also if you want.
Okay, to keep it in the air fryer, I just roll this like in the breadcrumbs and then I put it in a foil.
Yeah.
And
yeah, but you know, oil, the grease, the foil a bit so that, you know, it's not too dry.
Okay. And girls, I think we should just bring in this cooking part.
I think we are all done. And
all done. Yeah. My cutlets are done. I have a fish fingers. Not fish fingers.
Oh,
cheese fingers.
Fish fingers, yeah.
So cheese fingers. I think we just have to display it wherever we can.
Yeah. Should we go and display?
You can do a display, but you need to clear our tables in a minute.
Sorry.
Yes. Pardon? Can't hear you. Yeah, fine. Nice and brown.
Yeah.
Eat one and see before you serve it to anybody.
Yeah.
They're not going to count.
Girls, we need to wind up, so get to display the items.
I think we make the picture afterwards.
Can I go? Do I need to do something before going?
Shalini, may I ask some question?
Yeah, pardon?
My router is getting really cranky now. So yeah. I need to leave.
Okay.
So I can send the picture, click the picture of the phone and send it to you, or should I do it right now? Or
no, I can do it later.
No, no, wherever you have. Yeah, you can always put in the comment section. And or we'll post it, post all the pictures.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you, Chef. So I can actually make it regularly now.
So I've made this and I'm like clicking a picture and definitely will send you. But
Hello.
Okay, so Charu, can we get you wind up?
Yeah, sure.
Okay guys, if all of us want to show any fun dish into the screen, let's do that before we say bye bye.
Okay, yeah.
Anyone dish you want to show? Let's get it near the camera and then let's say bye byes.
Yeah.
So here are the.
Okay. I hope we all had fun. I mean, I did. I hope you all. Fun.
I hope all of you enjoy. More than anything, all of them should enjoy the food.
Thank you so much, Shalini. It was really nice.
Lovely cook party.
And Jayanti and Charu and Shiny, well done. And it was very good. We enjoyed a lot. I think after many, many, many weeks or months, probably we enjoyed. So it was really nice. Thank you so much. All of us will share.
And please, see, I want an honest feedback on the food after... True. Everybody eats because it's not that, oh, it's nice. Because variations are there. Each one will have, you know, somebody will say, no, you could have done this, you can do this. So each of us can try a different method also next time.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, so guys, let's send a small video to each other after we zoom out from here.
Yeah, place everything on the table. Take a picture before you have your family. I know everybody will be, you know, really hungry.
That will be very kind of you.
Thank everyone you so will be
for joining us, guys. And I'm sure you know this virtual closeness is something that all are gunning for. And it's just nice to meet you over the internet. So thank you once again. And don't forget to catch our weekly every Saturday. It's either at 4 p.m. or 5 p.m. Thank you so much. And thank you, Shalini, again.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for inviting me for this show. I really enjoyed it.
Yeah, we did too. Thank you, Jayanti.
Thank you, Jayanti.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye. Thank you. Bye.
Bye. Bye.